you turn on the news and you get to hear the things which is very discouraging. You buy a newspaper, you get very discouraged and you feel you are depressed. What is happening with the coronavirus? What is happening with the lockdown? Or what is happening around the world? It is very much depressing. And you feel actually there is nothing, there is no hope you can hold on. But actually there it in this time when we are asking for hope, when we lost our hope, we can hold on as a Christian that our hope is Lord Jesus Christ. As a Christian, we can look up our Heavenly Father who sent his one and only Son into this broken world, who lived among us, and he gave himself on the cross for us. And on the third day he resurrected. He is the one who gives us hope. He is the one who keeps us going. But still, it comes to the stage where actually it is very much concerning what is happening just next door. Not next door, physically next door. Probably physically next door, there is domestic violence. There is a anger. There is a hunger. There are lots of things probably happening next door physically. But next door of Britain, in France, last couple of years, lots of things are happening. And where people are in the stage that they lost their hope. It all starts with someone who decides to practice their freedom of expression and draw the picture of one of the best false prophet Muhammad. Suddenly world changed upside down. But if you go back, you get to see these things are happening in this broken world because in the beginning, man and woman choose to disobey God. Adam and Eve, first man and first woman, choose to disobey God. They run from God. Throughout centuries and centuries, humans are intentionally running away from God. We are prostituting top of every hill, under every tree, to lots of different things, to different gods, to money, to individuals. There is something is happening. People are simply running away from God. While we run away from God, we get to see hope is getting farther and farther. Paris. First event takes place in 2015. Are you aware that 248 lives are being taken away with the magic word of Allahu Akbar? There is a magic word. If I say Jesus Christ is Lord, none of you will run away from me. But if someone else screams Allahu Akbar, lots of people will run away. Because there is something magical in those words. Muhammad, prophet of Islam, said Allah Akbar, and then he got rid of the Kaaba. He killed from 600 to 800 men one Saturday afternoon. And it all started with the magic word of Allah Akbar. Allah is greater if you translate it to English. In his time, he simply encouraged and spurred people's life to be taken away from them because they critiqued Muhammad or they rejected Muhammad. Quran is full of verses where people are told to be killed because of their belief. We live in a world where people are hunting for hope. People are hunting for hope. Let me take us back to the next door neighbor, friends. Your neighbor, I'm just here, immigrant. British neighbor, France. So this is Telegraph for Friday. Okay? Check out numbers with me. 2015, January 7th and 9th. Charlie Hebdo office and supermarket. 12 people were killed after drawing the picture of false prophet Muhammad. Sorry, newspaper doesn't say false prophet. Newspaper simply tells us prophet Muhammad. But as a Christian, by default, I cannot say Muhammad is a prophet. Muhammad is one of the best false prophet ever. 2015, 12 individuals were killed simply because people could not handle the picture of Muhammad. Very sad. 12 people's lives are being taken away from them. Those people had favorite colors. Those people had favorite flowers, favorite chocolate. They had children, they had wife, they had loved ones. But because they involved in the drawing picture of false prophet Muhammad, magic word of Allah Akbar caused their life to be taken away from them. That's 2015, 12 people, okay? November 13, 2015, 131 people were killed in shooting in Paris by ISIS supporters, by the supporters of Islamic State. 131 people. These 131 people had favorite flowers. They had favorite chocolate. They had favorite food. They had their loved ones. But the followers of Islam, supporters of the Islamic State, took their life. 131 life is gone. 131 plus 12, okay? Following year, 2016, July 14, 86 people are killed. 86 people are killed by someone to drive through one. 86 people had favorite flowers. 86 people had favorite chocolates. 86 people had favorite food. 86 people had loved ones. But their life is taken away from them by the magic, someone who uses the magic word of Allah Akbar. Let's add the numbers so far. 12 plus 131 plus 86. Even number one is already too much, but we are already in 200s. Even taking the life of one individual is too much, but so far, 2015, 12 people plus 131 people, 2016, 86 people. Can I just gently encourage you to make sure you are keeping the rule of six people? 2017, following year, another attack to the cathedral, and people are being killed again by followers of ISIS, supporters of ISIS. I don't think I should say followers of ISIS, because ISIS is following the teachings of Muhammad and teachings of the Quran. Following year, March 23, 2018, gunman kills one person in the supermarket and three more after that. Four people are being killed March 23rd, 2018. So far what we have is 12 people and 131 people in 2015. In 2016, 86 people. 2017, one person. 2018, four people. And 2018, December 11, gunman kills five people and injures 11 people in Christmas market. And those individuals, let me remind you, they are people like you and like me, who has got favorite colors. They are humans who, And so breathe out and breathe in. They've got their loved ones, but their life is being taken away from someone who identified himself or herself, in this occasion himself, as the followers of Muhammad, as the followers of the Quran, as the followers of ideology of Islam. 2019, 3rd October, man is being killed again. 2020, April the 4th, two people are killed, five people are wounded. 25th September, 2020, two people were killed. Simply Charlie Hebdo published the cartoons. October 16, 2020. Teacher Samuel Paty was killed. I'm not giving you the details of how those people are killed, by the way. Those of you who watched the news, you saw Samuel Paty's body was separated from his head. His head was in somewhere else and his body was somewhere else. They were simply beheaded by someone who simply could not defend his prophet theologically, and got offended by the pictures of his prophet, decides to kill someone who teaches our next generation, who equips our next generation. And on Friday or on Thursday, three Christians are being killed in the church while they are worshiping. While they are trying, can I ask you to separate and make sure you are keeping the rules of six?
Can you start again at two, because they want to close the whole lot down. I'm trying to keep holding open at the moment. There's too many people.
Six is what I was trying to say.
Can you please make sure you separate it and go away? Yeah. Not go away, but like go on, yeah, steps back.
We're trying to keep it open, but there's too many people in a confined area. Yeah? Too many people. We need to spread right out. Thank you.
Three Christians were killed while they are in the church trying to practice their belief, worshipping triune God. One of the sisters is being beheaded. My Christian sister is being beheaded, and you know what is her crime according to Islam? Her crime is to be Christian. If you're not Muslim today, that is your crime according to Islam. Let me bring up the Quranic verses so that none of us thinks we are making the things up. If you are not a Muslim, you are already got a label on yourself that you should be killed.
Have you noticed?
You can't see, brother. You cannot see on the camera, but let me express what just happened. Followers of Muhammad is simply praising their brothers who punched me last week. They are praising their Muslim brothers who punched me last week. I already moved on from that. That was last week. Today, I acknowledge actually life is getting more serious. People need Lord Jesus Christ much urgently. I moved on from that. But I am disappointed that individuals are praising a man who simply thinks it's all right to punch someone at speaker's corner, at the heart of freedom of speech, because person is practicing freedom of speech. And they have zero problem for them to practice their freedom of speech.
Yeah.
But when it comes to my freedom of speech, people's feelings are being hurt. My feelings are being hurt. Seriously, can you hear this? Look, my heart is being crushed right now. That's the crushing sound of my heart. But no one cares about my feelings. No one.
The worst of creatures. That hurts my feeling too.
Someone calls you the worst of creatures. And that someone is Allah.
Can you just take a break and start again about 10 to 2? Yeah.
Okay.
Take an intermission.
Okay, let me just summarize. Let me just summarize what I'm saying. While people are losing their hope, while people are feeling unsafe, while people starting thinking about shutting down the freedom of speech, while people are start thinking about the death, remember, Lord Jesus Christ, crucified and risen Lord, offers you hope and offers you eternal life.
Amen.
I'm afraid I have to stop here because there is too much crowd and you have to move away. Otherwise, future of Speaker's Corner doesn't look good.
We're just going to move somewhere else.
All this here is Speaker's Corner. Use the space. Use it. We're trying to keep it open for you. But if you're all closing in, we'll have to close it because of the COVID legislation. Work with us. We're trying to keep it open.
Tune, have you got a megaphone?
You can't use megaphone here. You can't use megaphone.
The sound was okay on the screen, but I couldn't hear anything. It might be my head.